Hi there, this is your personal CFO here, and I'm back with another video. Now in this video, I'm going to talk about how to maximize your purchasing power. We're going to talk about how your decisions can allow for you to maximize every dollar that you earn. Specifically, I'm going to be talking about purchasing power parity. A way to simplify this concept is to really just explain how far does a dollar in one country go versus that same dollar in another country. How many goods can you purchase with that dollar here versus where you can buy them elsewhere. Now the same thing can be applied to states as well. They talk about per capita personal income, and then they show you here how much a dollar, and this is from 2019, will carry forward in various states. So the average $1 in US currency will give you less value in certain states, you know, the places where it's maybe more desirable to live, versus other states where maybe that dollar will go a little bit further. So in the states where the dollar is showing as being worth more than a dollar, that means your dollar carries further. Now we'll talk about how that can play into decision making. Now here's a really cool graphic, set of graphics that I found on this Economic Policy Institute website. It's called the Family Budget Map, and I'll include the link down below for those of you that wish to use it. It goes to show that where you live will certainly have an impact on your costs. Also, where you live has an impact on how much you may get paid. So first, let's show the total budget. As you can see, typically along the coasts, typically where there are big cities, it's going to be more expensive to live there. It's also going to be more expensive to live in places that are maybe islands, such as Hawaii. As you can see, housing is more expensive in certain areas than maybe it would be for, let's say, food. So food is certainly not as expensive in the middle of the country. It can be more expensive in places where it's more mountainous or more challenging to get to, or maybe there's more rain. Childcare, I think this is a great graphic. It shows you childcare can be much less expensive in some places and more expensive in others. Look at this really concentrated blue area up here in the state of New York. The state of, I believe this is Massachusetts here, or how you want to determine what your transportation costs will be. So healthcare could be an important one depending upon which stage of your life you're in. As you can see, states like West Virginia, not great for healthcare costs, much more expensive. Versus places like, you could say, New Mexico, very inexpensive when it comes to healthcare costs. That doesn't mean the care is better, but it certainly determines how far your dollar will go. Now I'm going to substantiate that point with this income graphic. It shows the United States and where you can expect to make the most money depending upon where you live. You see a large focus in the most, you know, expensive areas. So as you can see, San Francisco, Los Angeles, New York, down here, Washington, D.C., all the way up through Boston, these blue areas. Now, if you can find a discrepancy and you, let's say, go to a city where you can earn a lot of money, but it isn't that expensive, you could probably do really well for yourself. Now, I have another graphic here where it shows you how expensive it is to live in a given area. This is a really cool chart. I've included this one below, but it shows you the average price per square foot to live in that area. So as you can see, the taller the bar chart, certain areas here, let's just look at the California area, it could be as high as $600 per square foot. Whereas if you were to look, let's say, out in Tennessee here, where it might be very favorable to live, but a little less populated, you may get less than $100 per square foot. So this is a great resource. I certainly consider you using this as well as the other information I provided to try and determine what's best for you. Like, I do know there are a lot of people moving to, let's say, the Sun Belt, but places like Massachusetts and New York are relatively very expensive when compared to places like, let's say, North Carolina, where there's the research triangle, and you can maybe earn a lot of money but not pay as much to live there. Now, this graphic here just simply shows you where are we seeing growth in terms of the counties, in terms of the people living there. Now, take this with a grain of salt. This is from 2020 to 2021, so we've seen a large change in living habits for people due to working from home and due to COVID. But I think this is just a cool graphic to share. You know, you can see that a lot of people are moving to, let's say, Florida or the eastern part of Texas, whereas they're moving out of those big cities like Los Angeles and San Francisco and even New York. So this is a helpful tool as well. Now, this is the price you could pay in the top tax rate in any given state here in the U.S. I certainly think it's important to note how much you could spend on taxes. So let's say you were to work in New York City, but you live in Pennsylvania. You know, there could be some tax benefits there. Certainly talk to a tax preparer, a tax accountant, or a CPA to determine what's best for you. But certainly your decisions matter. Now, the final topic I'm going to touch upon is purchasing power by country. Now, let's say you want to travel and you enjoy traveling quite a lot and you want to travel every year. Well, your U.S. dollar will go much further if you travel to a country where that dollar is worth a lot more than, let's say, if you were to travel to a really expensive part of the U.S. Let's say your one U.S. dollar is worth, let's say, 10 pesos in the Dominican Republic or in Mexico. You see that here. You have the light blue, which is 1, so it's saying a 1-to-1 ratio. And then you look here at Mexico, and it's a 1-to-10 ratio. So for every $1 you have, every one U.S. dollar you have, that could be 10 Mexican pesos. So you could get a lot more for your money traveling to that country than if you stayed here in the U.S. The same could apply to any of these various countries. You could say a lot of Central America is much more inexpensive. You could say parts of the Pacific, some beautiful countries over here. So if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to hit that like button. If you want to follow along for future videos, I certainly encourage you to hit the subscribe button. Also, I certainly encourage you to leave your comments in the comment section below. I'd love to hear from you. With all that being said, thank you for watching. I hope you have a great evening.